Hello and welcome to another episode of The Hobbit Abridged. This is chapter 16, titled The Thief in the Night. It's a very short chapter. I think it's the shortest chapter in the whole book. So, it's about 6 pages in my version. So it shouldn't take us too long. The last chapter was The Gathering of the Clouds, and that was a real build-up chapter, trying to set the stage for the big battle to come. Or maybe not. Who knows if there's going to be a battle? Well, I do, and most people watching this probably do as well, but you never know. So this chapter... Last chapter, it was just mostly Bard came to Thorin, was like, hey, can you give us some cash? Thorin was like, nah, it's mine, so can you go away? And they also sent word to Dane of the Iron Hills. So let's see what happens now. Chapter 16, A Thief in the Night. Because they were left in a siege situation, so they'll hold up in the mountain, surrounded by the host of men and elves. So since then, it's been several days, and they're just kind of sorting through the treasure, having a great time, I imagine. And Thorin, he's still looking for the Arkenstone, of course, and he says that it's worth more than a river of gold. And as readers, we know that Bilbo, of course, has the Arkenstone. He's a cheeky little bugger, and he's kept it for himself. Which, once again, I said this last chapter, but I don't know why he's actually done this. But anyway. So, yeah, and Bilbo, he hears Thorin talking about how much he wants the Arkenstone. And he begins to feel afraid, wondering what would happen if they found out that Bilbo had hidden it in his pillow. But he doesn't speak of it, and he has the beginnings of a plan in his little head, it says. So, we'll see what those plans are soon. And it says that this kind of just continues, this just sorting through the treasure. When the ravens return, they tell him that Dane's coming with 500 dwarves. Not many dwarves. 500 dwarves. Not many at all. But I suppose we don't know specifically how large the host of the elves and men are, but I can't imagine 500 is enough. That is just a really low amount. But anyway, he's coming. They're about 2 days' march from Dale, so yeah, whatever. Rorik, the crow, the raven, I mean, he says that they can't reach the mountain unmarked, so there's going to be a battle kind of out the front, probably. And this is going to be bad, because although Dane and his buddies are pretty great fighters, it says, they're gonna be overcome, it says. So, yeah. I don't know why he's not bringing more men. Maybe 500's all that he has. It's possible. So, yep. Okay. And Rorik gives some counsel. He says to Thorin that this treasure is likely to be your death, though the dragon is no more. So that's a bit of foreboding messaging there from Rorik. And we'll see how that plays out in the coming chapters. But Thorin, he doesn't care. He's pretty greedy, as we know. And he says that the winter and snow, so like winter's coming on, and he's like, winter and snow will bite both men and elves. And then they'll hopefully just kind of leave or something. That's the plan. It's not a great plan, to be honest, but that is the plan that Thorin is going to go with. And that night, Bilbo obviously knows what's going on, and it says that he made up his mind. We don't know what he's planning yet, but we get some ideas. As soon as it's dark, he sneaks off near the gate, and he pulls out some rope, and he brings the Arkenstone wrapped in a rag. And he climbs to the top of the wall, and Bomber's there. It's his turn to watch, it says. Bomber is complaining that it's cold. And it says, I wish we could have a fire up here as they have in the camp. So I'm not sure why they wouldn't be allowed a fire up there, but anyway, not allowed a fire. So Bilbo's like, it's warm inside. So he's saying, you should go in there and not hang around here. But Bomber's like, I can't, I'm on duty till midnight. Yeah, and we learn that Bomber, he disagrees with Thorin on pretty much everything that's happening at this point. But he doesn't really, he doesn't dare kind of speak up or anything about that. Yeah. So, and then Bilbo and Bomber are just having a good chat. Kind of reminiscing of the good old times, wishing for better days. Bilbo says, I wish I could feel the grass on my toes again. Bomber, he wants a strong drink and a soft bed. But this is obviously wishful thinking. But Bilbo says, I'll take your turn watch if you want, and you can go inside and sleep. I'm not really too tired, apparently. And Bomber's like, thanks, Bilbo, you're a great guy. You're a real trustworthy and loyal fellow, he's thinking. Yeah. But he says that make sure you wake me up before you wake the next person up. So it seems like I've done the watch, because otherwise everyone will tease him. So Bilbo's like, yep, I'll do that. Don't you worry. See you later. So Bomber goes, and then Bilbo puts on the ring, fastens the rope, and he slips down over the wall and was gone. So he had about 5 hours before him. 5 hours. So it's like 7 p.m., I guess. Anyway, whatever. So, yep, cool. It says that all the others were busy with Thorin, which is a strange little message, isn't it? Wonder what they're doing. Anyway. Cool. So this is basically just saying no one's going to go out to the wall. Everyone's doing stuff. So he has 5 hours. Should be pretty safe. So it's dark. And Bilbo's walking along on the path. Cool, next to the river and whatever. And he's making his way for the camp. Cool. I think he has to cross the river. It's not easy, but he does it. Falls in, apparently, a little bit. A little bit of the water gets a bit of a splash, but he makes it over. And, yeah. And the elves, apparently, some of the elves on guard hear this splashing in the river and they go and investigate. And that says, one of them says, that was no fish. There's a spy about. One of them says, they will help him more than us if it is that little queer little creature that is said to be their servant. So, of course, no one really knows what hobbits are, but the kind of rumor of Bilbo is obviously spread around that he's a little sneaky fellow. And Bilbo says, servant indeed. And, And he pulls off his ring and pops out from behind a rock. And they seize him, apparently. They ask if he's the dwarves' hobbit. What are you doing? How'd you get past our guards and everything? And he's like, Bilbo's pretty upfront. He's like, yep, I am Bilbo. I am part of your enemies. And yeah. And he's like, I want to speak with Bard in particular. They ask what your business is. And he says, my business is my own. No, he says, it's basically that, to be honest. He says, my business, it is my own, my good elves. And cool. But he does say, if you wish to go back to your own woods, then you should let me kind of go and do my thing. So Bilbo, we learn now, is conspiring with the enemy. But who's the real enemy in this story? Not sure. We'll find out. Cool. So that apparently took Bilbo 2 hours from the wall to get here. But he gets seated into a large tent with the fire there and everything. And the Elven King and Bard are there with Bilbo. So that's pretty nice. And Bilbo, he's a polite guy. He's saying, I'm pretty tired of all this whole war business and conflict and violence. I just kind of want to go home at this point. Where folk are more reasonable. So he's had enough with dwarves, it seems. But he says, I have an interest in this matter, 1/14th share to be precise. And he pulls out the Arkenstone, I think. Oh no, he pulls out Thorin's letter that apparently he's kept on him this whole time. So, yeah. Cool. They're going through some of the details, like, yeah, it's pretty unnecessary stuff, to be honest. And he says that Thorin will never give up. He'll rather starve on his pile of gold than to kind of concede in this little conflict. So Bard's like, whatever, let him do that. That'll be good for us. But Bilbo's like, yeah, fair enough, good strat. But winter's coming on. And also Dane and his armies, his 500 men are coming. So that's pretty bad news, I assume. But apparently the elves have already learnt about the dwarven reinforcements that are coming. So the elves also have some talking skills with the birds, I think. So maybe that's how they learnt that. Cool. Dane's less than 2 days away. 500 grim dwarves with him. Many have experience with goblin wars. That's in like Moria and that sort of stuff. And more up north as well in the... I forget what the mountains north of the Lonely Mountain is, but there's another mountain range there, I think, where there's some battles going on. Cool. When they get here, there'll be serious trouble, he says. And Bard's like, are you betraying your friends? Why are you telling us all this? And Bilbo's like, wow, you're really suspicious people. Well, I suppose Bilbo's the suspicious one, but they are very... they doubt Bilbo's kind of intentions here, I think. So, but Bilbo's like, I'm just trying to avoid trouble for everyone, so I'll make you an offer. And he draws out the Arkenstone, and everyone is very impressed, just like in... don't worry. Everyone's very impressed. This is the Arkenstone of Thrain, he says, the heart of the mountain. And I'll give it to you as a bargaining chip. And Bilbo, it says, gives it up, not without a shudder, not without a glance of longing. So the Arkenstone has a certain pull toward it as well, much like the ring or something, but obviously far less powerful, but it does have a certain draw to it. A marvelous kind of aura or something. But they're like, how is it even yours to give? Bilbo's like, it's kind of a grey area, a legal grey area, he says. I'm a burglar. That's what people say anyway, but I'm a pretty good guy. So I'm willing to kind of do this if we'll end the conflict, which is obviously wishful thinking, I think. Well, maybe not, but it's pretty wishful thinking. So that's what they do. The Elf King's very impressed. He's like, you're a great guy, but Thorin's really going to hate you. You should probably stay here with us. I wouldn't go back to them because they'll cast you off the wall, probably. But Bilbo's like, nah, thanks, but, you know, I'm not going to leave my friends after all we've been through. So it's a bit weird. Bilbo's sending some mixed messages here. Because on one hand, he's like, obviously betraying his friends. Like, he's giving an incredible bargaining chip to the enemy. But on the other hand, he's also willing to kind of stick with them till the end. So it's weird. It's weird. He's loyal to them, maybe as a people, but he's not loyal to their cause or the mission. Something like that. It's an interesting one. So he's like, anyway, I really gotta go. So they escort him back. Apparently, Bard salutes him. And then as Bilbo's leaving, an old man wrapped in a dark cloak rose from a tent door. And he says, well done, Mr. Baggins. There is always more about you than anyone expects. And it's Gandalf, of course. So Gandalf is back from his little mission that he had to do in Dol Guldur. Concerning the necromancer. So that's pretty cool. And Bilbo, he's obviously very happy, but there's no time for questions. But Gandalf's like, all in good time, my friend. Things are drawing toward the end now. There is an unpleasant time just in front of you, but keep your heart up. So Gandalf, he's showing a bit of foresight here. I suppose anyone can kind of see the impending doom coming. So maybe not Bilbo. Well, no, probably Bilbo as well. But he probably doesn't understand the true extent of what's about to happen. Because he's never experienced a war or a battle. He's probably never even seen someone die before. So anyway. And Gandalf continues saying, and he says, you may come through all right. There is news brewing that even the ravens have not heard. Good night. And Bilbo is puzzled but cheered by this. The news brewing that even the ravens have not heard. I assume that's the goblins or something. Or Bjorn. The eagles. It's hard to say because if it was the goblins, you'd think Gandalf would tell Bard and the Elven King, but maybe they know and that they just didn't tell Bilbo. I'm not sure, but that's pretty important information that an army of orcs is on the way to kill everyone. But anyway, maybe Gandalf knows that if he told Bilbo that, Bilbo would probably run away or something. Actually, I don't know if he would. I don't think he would at this point. He's pretty strong guy, pretty committed. So anyway, Bilbo, he goes back, climbs back over the gate. He unties the rope and everything, obviously. He wakes Bomber up at midnight. And he goes to sleep. Bilbo does, of course. And he forgets all his worries till the morning. As a matter of fact, he was dreaming of eggs and bacon, it says. So that's that chapter done. As I said, very short one, but we are getting very close to the end of the book now. There's still like two or three chapters left, but or maybe only two, no, three. Three, but they're quite short. In terms of page count, we are very much at the end of the book. So this chapter was, it's an alright one, I guess. It's just a kind of plot development point. We'll see how it all plays out with the rest of the characters and everything next chapter, obviously, but so I don't think it'll really make much of a difference, though. It seems that the doom is unavoidable despite Bilbo's best efforts. So thanks everyone for listening. I'll have another episode in a couple of days or something. So yeah, appreciate it.